Welcome back in the next session of social studies. Today I am going to start a new chapter which is what, where, how and when. These are the four elements which we trying to understand under the concept of history. So let's take an example. We and our family might be familiar with the means of transport, which would we say aeroplane. Our grandparents might be familiar with the means of transport, which would we say train and buses. And our great grandparents might be familiar with the means of transport, which would we say bullock carts. So what has happened over the years? Over the years, the time has changed, and this changes of time we can call the chronological changes and the temporal changes. In this past time, we study about the history. So let's take our first element, which is what. In what elements we studies about what kind of food they uses in past, what kind of clothes they wear, what kind of houses they were lived in. In the concept of what, we all things studies in the histories, and we know what type of culture, food and houses they adopted in the Harappa civilizations and Egyptian civilizations. So we are trying to know what type of concept. All these would we come under what concept? We can say also in simple terms, those who don't studies the past are condemned to repeat it. That means we can say that why Britishers invaded India. If we are not aware of these mistakes, what would happen in future? We have to face many problems, and we should not repeat the similar mistake in future. That's why we studies about history. I hope students you understand the what concept. So come to the next element, which is where. Where, in where concept we studies about from where they gathered food, from where they hunted, from where animal roaring, traveling, wars and kingdoms. These are the main elements of where concept. Before we understand the second questions, we have a simple code of understand the broader prospectus of history. History is the study of geographically, and geography is the study of historically. That means let's first we talk about geography. In geography we know how the origin of earth is formed, how the lands are formed, how the various continents are formed. So that we are trying to do, we are trying to see how they evolved, how they formed. Now how we can say that history is a study of geography, because we must know where the major kingdoms were, where the wars fought, what was the major trades were, what were the area which were fertile. Again, we must be able the area which are deserted. I hope students you understand what I want to say. So in the next session we will study about two elements of which is how and when. So if you have any questions, any queries, write in the comment box. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Have a nice day.